Hello and welcome to hackGVSU 2018. I wanted to demonstrate how to develop simple HTML apps for Blackboard Learn, which will be the first category of the hackGVSU event. We have a little bit about the categories under What Will I Learn section, because in fact, on the day of the hackathon, we're going to have trainings that are going to dig a little bit deeper into this technology and opportunities for students. So let's go ahead and start with how to get your own instance of Blackboard so that you can test and you can experiment with different widgets and applications. Well, it is as simple as navigating to the AWS Marketplace, so Amazon Web Services Marketplace, and for about 10 cents per hour, you can run your own Blackboard Learn. This system is going to charge only when it's up. When you turn it off, it is going to stay dormant, keeping your data until you start it up again. This is part of the Blackboard's Open Innovation Initiative and releasing their software through Amazon Web Services available to developers, but also to students, to anyone who wants to learn more about enterprise application development. That's really a great thing that the company is doing at this point. So we have one of these Blackboard demo systems installed, and we'll go ahead and log in. At this point, I have just a vanilla, clear, brand new system from Blackboard Learn with a couple of classes that I created. So let's start with the first category of the HTML development. As you can see, Blackboard Learn produces these welcome tabs for students and faculty. These tabs have portlets in Blackboard. They are called modules. And so this is what we're going to develop and to maybe add value to students as they log in to Blackboard. Or perhaps we'll have an application later for faculty as well. How do we do that? Well, first of all, we'll navigate to the system admin panel, and we will find the area for tabs and modules. From here, we'll go ahead and create a new module. So we'll just go ahead and create one called Hello World. Now this module will be of type HTML. Perhaps we'll select a category for it, and we'll go ahead and add a reference name. So at this point, we're just filling out metadata about the module. We do want to make it available, so let's go ahead and check these boxes. We'll press submit on that. And at this point, we're asked to provide the actual application code. Of course, this is a Hello World module, so we simply can say Hello World. But we could also go in the HTML view and then add HTML. We could add JavaScript. We could add an iframe. So anything we can do inside of such tools as Dreamweaver or FrontPage, we can present through this module. Let's go ahead and submit and complete this demo. We'll take us back to the initial tab. And now let's go ahead and add the module. So let's look for Hello, add this, and let's view the tab again. And here is the Hello World module. So the first category of our hackathon will be to develop simple applications that add value either to students, to faculty, or to the guest, because we can set up the login page to also have its own tab with these applications. Let's take it a step further. What if we have a little bit more advanced system developed on our own server somewhere, and we would like to present it through a module? Well, let's go ahead and move the module to the middle here, and let's renavigate to edit the module we just created. In this instance, what I will do is I will use an iframe in order to present an external application, which is a part of a gamification system. So we'll switch to the HTML view. We'll replace our code with an iframe where the source is going to be a specific web page, specific web application that is running on a system that we developed earlier. At this point, we're going to provide a width. Now, I will provide 100% because depending on where the module goes, in the middle or on the sides, the width may vary. And I can also provide height. Let's just go with 600 pixels for now. We can, depending on the content of the module, we can modify that. So let's go ahead and close the iframe. And as easily as this, we can now embed and integrate content that's more advanced at this HTML category. So during preview time, this does not actually render in the editor, but we'll see in a minute how it looks in the tab itself. So let's go ahead and refresh. All right, and at this point, what we see is that our simple Hello World is replaced with a jQuery application that is doing maybe a little bit scrolling, showing in this instance events inside of a gamified class. So we can see still the Hello World title, because what we have done so far is we just changed the content. If we wanted to change the properties, so we have the properties and the contents, the properties is where we are going to modify the title and perhaps who it appears to if we wanted to only specify selected roles. So let's go ahead and change that to another title and then also perhaps the reference name. We'll submit that. Let's go ahead and refresh one more time. And we can see that the system is updating our changes and integrating the HTML application that we have created. In the next video, I'll show you how to participate in the advanced category where we are going to pull data out of Blackboard into our own web server, into our own web application through REST API. And then we'll build some logic so that we can, first of all, recognize who the student is currently logged in, and then what courses they're part of. And we can provide some deeper integration into the system. Thank you.